This chapter is about year-end adjusting entries. At the end of the year, before we publish our financial statements, we have to go through all of the accounts and we have to pass off on the balances there. We cannot just accept what the computer is saying the balance is. A human being has to inspect the data that is in the accounts and pass off on those, on that data. If there's anything that's imperfect or needs to be updated, we do it now in the adjusting process. Let's look at the supplies account. Notice the numbers in blue. It appears that during the year we purchased $2,000 of supplies, and now at the end of the year, the balance in that account is still showing $2,000. But is that correct? Do we still have $2,000 of supplies? Do we want to show $2,000 as the amount of the assets on the balance sheet? Let's go count. Let's find out where we keep the supplies and take a look. And we'll do a quick count and we'll say more or less $500. Well, if we have $500, we must have used $1,500. We will credit supplies for $1,500. Now we have to debit something. We will debit supplies expense. Expenses are used assets. So at the end of the year, we'll take this asset and move it to the expense. That's a very common year-end adjusting entry. This is our second adjusting entry of this video. The first three adjustments that I'm going to talk about are almost exactly the same. All three are taking an asset and moving it to an expense. Let's look at the prepaid insurance account. The numbers in blue. It appears that on November 1st, we bought a six-month insurance policy for $6,000. That would amount to $1,000 per year for 6 months. At the end of the year, do we still have 6 months that are prepaid? No, because 2 months have passed, so 2 months have been used. We need to subtract 2 months out of this asset. The balance that we want to show on our balance sheet is 4 months going forward, or $4,000 of prepaid insurance that we still have. The adjustment is to credit prepaid insurance. Credit the asset to reduce the asset. What should we debit? Let's debit insurance expense. Here again, we are moving an asset to the expense account. An expense is a used asset. Let's look at the prepaid rent account. It appears that on September 1st, we prepaid one full year of rent. We paid $12,000 for 12 months rent. Is that the amount that we want to show as an asset at the end of the year? On December 31st, how many months are still prepaid? Well, 8, because 4 months have passed. We would like to show a balance of $8,000. Because 4 months have passed, we will have to subtract 4 months or $4,000 from this account. Let's credit the prepaid rent account, which is an asset, for $4,000. What should we debit? We'll debit rent expense. These first three were almost exactly the same, moving an asset to an expense at the end of the year. Okay, this one's a little different. Remember the last scenario, the last slide, where we were the tenant and we prepaid our rent? Well, let's change perspectives for this one. Let's be the landlord this time, but we'll use the same numbers. So we're the landlord, and on September 1st, we received $12,000 for 1 year of rent. We have not earned this money yet, So the accountants have to show on the books that we technically owe the money back. We have not earned it, so we cannot credit a revenue account yet. But as time rolls on, we can start moving some of this out of the liability and move it over to the revenue account. All right, so here we are on December 31st. We're inspecting this account, unearned revenue. We received this money 4 months ago. 4 months have passed. We can say that we have earned 4 months. So let's subtract $4,000, which represents 4 months. The balance in this account would be $8,000, representing 8 months that we still have not yet earned. We will debit unearned revenue for 4,000. What will we credit for 4,000? We'll credit the revenue. I just call it revenue. Your book calls it rent revenue. Wages. This one is, it's a little different. See this in blue? This is our typical Friday journal entry when we pay wages. We credit wages payable, or we could credit cash there. But the point is, every Friday we have an expense of 5,000. Now let's pretend we never hire anybody, we never fire anybody, and nobody ever gets a change of pay. That would be your typical Friday journal entry. Now, at year end, we have a situation. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. These employees are earning this money at the rate of about $1,000 a day. That's $5,000 a week. But wages, December 31st this year is Wednesday. The year end is in the middle of the week. The adjustment we need to make is to make sure that we record 3,000 of the expenses in last year and 2,000 of the expenses in the subsequent year. So on December 31st, we'll debit wages expense for the 3,000. This should be cash, really. But this one should be wages payable because it's not payday. The employees will not even know they have been part of an adjusting entry. January 2nd, let's say, is payday. We need to recognize the other 2 days. Whoops. We'll debit wages expense for the other 2 days of the week. And then we're going to debit wages payable to eliminate this liability that we just established 2 days ago. And we'll pay cash like normal. I'm going to do something different on this one. I'm going to give you the answer before I give you the explanation. The numbers in red, that's your answer. But let's go to the numbers in blue and talk through this. At the beginning of the year, we purchased some equipment for $100,000 and we paid cash. We know that this equipment is going to be used, and in this case, it's going to be used over 10 years. So we will depreciate 10% each year. To depreciate means to take out of the asset and move to the expense. Slowly, systematically, remove the asset and move it to the expense account. So just like we've done in previous, we are going to credit the assets and debit the expense. But in this case, it's different. We're going to use a contra account called accumulated depreciation. Now, I'm going to make a separate video on what is a contra account. But just know that accumulated depreciation, think of it as the right side, the credit side of the equipment account. In other words, we're taking the equipment account and splitting it into two accounts so that we do not mix debits and credits. Some people think that there's value in preserving separate the debits and credits so that when we make our financial statements, we don't have just one net line item that says 90,000, the net of 100 debit and 10 on the credit side. We don't show one line item for 90,000. We're going to show two line items, one for 100,000 and another for 10,000, and we'll even show a third line item for 90. So this tells us, it preserves some information. It preserves the original cost of the asset, and it gives us an idea of how old it is. If you see that the accumulated depreciation is 10,000 and you compare that to the purchase price of 100,000, you could know that the asset is about 1/10 used. In the future, we will have a chapter dedicated to depreciation, and I'll teach you several different formulas for calculating more precisely the depreciation per year. Interest. Let's look at the numbers in blue. It appears that on November 1st, we borrowed money. So on November 1st, we debited cash, we credited notes payable. Let's say that we have to pay this money back in 1 year, no monthly payments, just one payment, principal plus interest in 1 year. Now here we are on December 31st. What adjustment do we need to make? Well, interest has accrued on this debt. Even though we don't have to pay it yet, we do have to show that interest has accrued and we owe it. Even though it's not due yet, we have incurred the interest. So we will debit interest expense. We'll credit interest payable. And let's just say $500 has accrued on the loan. Okay, here we have another situation. This time, instead of borrowing the money, we're going to make a loan to somebody else, and they're going to owe money to us. So let's say that on November 1st, we gave someone $50,000, and the terms are that they're going to pay us back in 1 year, principal plus interest, no monthly payments. Okay, here we are on December 31st. We have earned 2 months of interest. Now, it's not due yet. They don't have to pay us today, but we have to show on the books that we have earned the money and we have interest receivable. We will debit interest receivable and we'll credit interest revenue for the $800 that has accrued on the loan. In another video, I'll show you how to calculate interest. This one's an easy one, and so is the next one. At the end of the year, we have to ask ourselves, is there any client that we have forgotten to bill? If yes, well, just send them a bill. Now, you're already late, maybe the year end is over, but you're going to send them a bill, but you know that you earned it last year. So what we'll do is we'll debit accounts receivable and we'll credit revenue for whatever the bill is, $1,000. That way we can make sure our assets and our revenues are up to date before we publish financial statements. Another question we have to ask ourselves is, at the end of the year, are there any bills that we owe that we haven't received yet? Well, there's always going to be a lag in receiving your bills, so we have to estimate. In this case, let's say we estimate 9,000, and let's say that represents lots of little bills. Well, what account should we debit if it represents the sum of lots of little bills and you're not exactly sure? Well, that's the problem. What do you debit? Why don't we just debit something vague and then we'll delete it next year, and as the bills come in, we'll process them. So for now, let's just call it maybe accrued expenses or operating expenses. We're going to have $9,000 more of expenses, and we're going to owe this money. We'll pay it when the bills come in. Accounts. We'll credit accounts payable. That's the end of our 10 adjustments. If you learned these 10, well, most other adjustments that you would ever need to make resemble these 10. In closing, I want to mention the matching principle. This is a vocabulary term in this chapter, and it is the whole reason why we are doing all these adjustments. We want to make sure that the expenses are in the correct year, and also the revenue is in the correct year. We cannot recognize revenue until after we earn it. There are some exceptions if you have long-term contracts, but we won't see those in this semester. Once we're satisfied with all the balances and all of the accounts, then we are ready to publish financial statements.